Hi, and welcome to Jamie DeRoy and Friends. Tonight we have a very special show for you. We are here to celebrate the Tony Award winners, but we also have a very special guest, my friend and my director, Barry Kleinbord, I have asked to co-host with me. He knows more about the theater than anyone I know.
Okay.
Well, welcome.
Well, thank you. And wasn't Ariana DeBose fantastic as the host?
She was terrific. She's beautiful. She sings great. And she is so personable. I loved her. And it was so different than any other year.
I agree.
It was great to be back at Radio City, too, and to be live and in person. I loved it.
And congratulations, because you are a co-producer on two productions that won the most Tonys that night. Congratulations to you.
Thank you. Well, Company won 5 Tonys, and the Lehman Trilogy won 5 Tonys. But let's look at Company first.
Great.
Among its 5 Tonys was Best Revival of a Musical, written by Stephen Sondheim and George Firth. For Best Director of a Musical, Marianne Elliott won her 4th Tony Award.
Yes, because she had previously won for War Horse, The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime, and the revival of Angels in America, which you were also involved with, if I remember correctly.
Well, that was exciting. And we want to congratulate Matt Doyle for winning Featured Actor in a Musical.
And Best Featured Actress in a Musical, Patti LuPone. This was her 3rd win. She had previously won for Evita and a revival of Gypsy, but this was her first time in the featured category.
The last award they won was for Scenic Design for a Musical. It went to Bunny Christie.
Right.
Here is a look at the engaging Company.
Phone rings, door chimes, in comes Company. No strings, good times, room humps, Company.
You can see Company at the Bernard Jacobs Theater. The Lehman Trilogy won 5 Tony Awards, including Best Play, written by Stefano Massini and Ben Power. It also won Best Direction of a Play for Sam Mendes and for its lead actor, Simon Russell Beale.
And it won for Scenic Design, S. Devlin, and Lighting Design, John Clark. It's interesting, a cast of 3. All three were nominated, Adam Godley and Adrian Lester, and they were all fantastic. And I think that was a really tough category for the Tonys to have to decide.
It was, and they could have canceled each other out, but
Right. Anyway,
that's showbiz.
But it doesn't take anything away from how great the other performers were. And what an evening in the theater that was.
Yes, and you know, it was just announced that it's going back to London next year.
Right.
And I know that it will end up in certain major cities in the United States, so be on the lookout. At the Tony Awards, the biggest award of the evening is always saved to last, and that is always Musical of the Year. This year, it went to A Strange Loop by Michael R. Jackson.
Yes, he also won for Best Book of a Musical, and he was nominated for Music and Lyrics, a triple threat. I mean, he did book, music, and lyrics.
My girls can do anything, can't they? Black boys must always obey their mothers. White girls can do anything, can't they, can't they, can't they, can't they? Don't get to make noise, don't get to fantasize.
the show had been off-Broadway, and during its off-Broadway run, it won the Pulitzer Prize. So it already had a great pedigree before it moved to Broadway. Still, it was an untested writer, an untested cast, a young man, Jacques Helspive, who was making his Broadway debut. There was a lot of unknowns with the project.
Right.
And the producers took a great risk putting it on Broadway.
And it was so groundbreaking, but look for yourself.
Mom is napping on the couch and Dad cuts the grass while I watch TV all day long, young and the restless, like one lone black gay boy I knew who chose to turn his back on the Lord. One lone black gay boy I knew who chose to turn his back on the Lord. Dad is drunken on the couch while Mom eats a pork chop. Daily bread mill, daily treadmill, won't ever stop. One lone black gay boy I knew who chose to turn his back on the Lord. One lone black gay boy I knew who chose to turn his back on the Lord. I am lying on the couch, I dream that I'm flying, flapping both my wings so hard to keep me from dying, with the crown of God-forsaken thorns on my head. Like all those black gay boys I knew who chose to go on back to the Lord. All those black gay boys I knew who chose to go on back to the Lord.
MJ, the Michael Jackson musical, won 4 Tony Awards. It won Best Choreography for Christopher Wheeldon, who happened to also direct the show.
Right.
And it won Best Actor in a Musical for Miles Frost, who is another first time out. Wow.
Yes, and in fact, Jamie, you may remember this, right after they started opening, he hurt his leg or something and missed like 3 weeks or 4 weeks, so it was a while before the voters could actually get to see the performance, and so it's remarkable that everybody caught up and got to see him do the show.
But when they caught it, it was amazing.
And the producers were right to not let you see the understudy because of what Miles Frost did in the show.
Exactly.
It also won 2 other awards. It won for Best Lighting, Natasha Katz, and Best Sound Design by Gareth Owen.
Yes.
And
you can still catch it at the Neil Simon Theater, but now tonight you can see a little bit of it right here.
Let's.
Okay, everybody, let's get started.
Where do you want to begin?
From the top.
Places.
And. Eyes up. Yeah. There you go. Beautiful. That's it. And 5, 6, 7, come on.
Thank
Don't stop. Looking great, everybody. Keep going.
MJ, Lynn Nottage was nominated for a book for writing the book for MJ, but she was also nominated in the Best Play category. And I believe it's the first time that somebody was nominated in both book of a musical and play in the same season. Clearly, this was a big year for women writers.
Which brings us to Six, starring six women playing the ex-wives of Henry VIII.
Yes, they had short but interesting lives. Six won for score for Toby Marlowe and Lucy Moss, and it also won for best costume design for a musical, Gabriella Slade.
Yes.
The costumes are fantastic, I have to say.
Amazing. And by the way, you can see some of them when the Museum of Broadway opens, so look out for that one.
But first, can we see some of Six?
Why not?
Take it.
Divorced. Beheaded. Died.
Divorced.
Beheaded. Survived. New York City, we are! Listen up, let me tell you a story.
Welcome to the show, to the history mix. Switching up the flow as we add the prefix. Everybody knows that we used to be six wives, but now we're ex-wives.
You must think that I'm crazy,
continues at the Brooks Atkinson Theater. Well, Six was all women, but Take Me Out was an all-male cast, and what a cast they were. It won for Best Revival of a Play, written by Richard Greenberg.
By the way, it had won Best Play when it was first done, so this was a second win for the play.
Right, and it was done originally off-Broadway at the Public Theater. I remember it so well.
Right.
And it also won Featured Actor for Jesse Tyler Ferguson, who we all love and adore.
Yeah.
Here is a look at Take Me Out.
Usual winners this season was Dana H, which won two Tony Awards for Deirdre O'Connell for Best Actress in a Play and for Michaele Fixell for Sound Design. This really was such an exciting evening in the theater because Deirdre O'Connell lip-synced the entire thing. It was a recording of the playwright's mother telling a story of something that happened to her many years ago that the playwright didn't even know had happened to her. So the levels in this evening were extraordinary, and I couldn't believe what Deirdre O'Connell accomplished.
I agree.
Doing that for 65 minutes or 70 minutes nonstop.
And it moved from the Vineyard Theater to Broadway,
right.
And she was magical. And the playwright, by the way, was Lucas Nath, who I adore.
I think he's one of our greaties. I really do. I love everything he does. Well, I do.
Where Six was about English history, Paradise Square was about American history that
yes.
took place in the Civil War.
Well, it was about the draft riots that happened in New York during the Civil War. And but what everybody talked about that night at the awards was the performance that won Best Actress in a Musical, Joaquina Kulakongo. I remember Ariana DeBose came back and she said, I'm still trying to take in the performance of Joaquina Kulakongo. A great and a surprising performance. It was the only award that Paradise Square got, but again, in a season full of so many female performances of such caliber, clearly everybody thought this was one of the greatest.
And I met her because she was on Slave Play.
Right, which you were a co-producer.
I didn't even know she sang at that point, so I was thrilled and surprised, but mostly thrilled.
Yeah.
So congratulations. And here is a look at Paradise Square.
There's a song that fills the air when the five points comes alive with a striking sound of different people fighting to survive. In the city's biggest slum, on a street in disrepair, I built a little Eden. What we are inside here, we all are free. We love who we want to love with no apology.
69 who fight on our behalf. The whores and drunks and lowlifes will be getting their last laugh.
The immigrants must approve.
We immigrants must approve.
We approved since time began.
Again, again, again.
We're just as much American.
Dominique Morisseau's Skeleton Crew won a Tony Award for Featured Actress in a Play, and it went to Felicia Rashad.
This was her second win. She won in 2004 for Best Actress in a Play. And it was the first time a black actress had won that award. And she was nominated the following year in the same category for August Wilson's Gem of the Ocean. She didn't win that year, but I love that people like Felicia Rashad keep coming back to the theater. I thought her performance was remarkable in Skeleton
Crew. It certainly was. And hats off. Congratulations. Thornton Wilder's The Skin of Our Teeth won one Tony Award. It was presented by Lincoln Center.
Yes, it won for Best Costume Design for Montana Levi Blanco. And those costumes were fantastic.
Incredible. We all like the special Tony Awards, and this year, a Lifetime Achievement Award was bestowed on Angela Lansbury. Her career spanned 75 years, and the Tony Awards have been around for 75 years.
Well, her career is remarkable, and she started out, you know, she was only 17 years old, or 18 years old when she got nominated for her first Oscar.
Whoa.
for Gaslight. And but she wanted to make it on stage. And the first few times she did, the first three times she was not nominated, that she did plays in New York. But she said that she learned so much doing those plays. But when she came back to Broadway in Mame in 1966, that was her first Tony. And then she could do no wrong. She won for Dear World, she won for a revival of Gypsy, she won for Sweeney Todd. Those were all actress in a musical, and then she won featured actress for a play that you were involved
with. Blythe Spirit.
Blythe Spirit. And again, a remarkable woman. I got to work with her on an album. And
oh, wow.
It was a wonderful experience. And it was a show that had closed out of town that they were recording 12 years after it closed. And they asked me to write the liner notes. And I wrote the notes about what the plot of the show was. And I showed it to her. And she read it. And she said, "This is terrific. I didn't know till now what the show was about." And that, how could you not love a woman like
everybody
that?
Loves Angela Lansbury. So we want to say our heartiest congratulations to her.
Yes. And she was also presented, the award was acknowledged by her co-star in Sweeney
From
Todd.
From Sweeney Todd.
Sweeney Todd, Len Carey, and also a Tony Award winner. So there was so much history, in that room.
A ton. Among the special Tony Awards that were given out, we want to acknowledge Robert Wankel, president of the Schubert Organization. He was given this award for his humanitarian and charitable work. He'd been involved with Broadway Cares Equity Fights AIDS for the last 20 years. There is no one that cares more about the theater community than Robert Wankel. We thank him for everything he has done and continues to do. Thank you and congratulations. To wrap up our Tony winners, Connor McPherson's Girl from the North Country won one award.
Yes, it won for Best Orchestrations, Simon Hale.
Exactly. And those orchestrations were of songs of Bob Dylan.
Yes, and I like that the show, again, is going to, even though it ended its limited run, it is announced a tour next fall, so other cities will get to experience Girl from the North Country.
And it's really quite an experience. Here's a look.
Pistol shots ring out in the ballroom night. Enter Patty Valentine from the upper hall. She sees the bartender in a pool of blood. Cries out, "My God, they've killed them all."
Here comes the story of the hurricane. The many authorities came to blame.
I was lying down in the rain without any the road.